Hi guys, Greg here and welcome back to my channel. Today it's another video from my setting out series, and in today's video I'm going to show you the Leica TS15 and I show you a few accessories which come in with it. The prism, pole, I'm going to show you the charger, how to charge batteries, and I'm going to show you controller as well. So let's go! We got the big charger here for four batteries, and that's what you need actually when you're using TS15. You need big two batteries and two small batteries for the controller. And just to take it out, it's just to slide it down, and if you're gonna slide this one up, you're gonna start charging. So that's it with the batteries really, and I'm gonna show you later how to exchange the batteries in controller and total station. We got a pole here with the holder and with the bubble so we can level it, and we're gonna install later controller. We got the prism, which is as you can see here, it's 23.1 millimeter constant. You always find on each prism, so you always find the information like this, so then when you're gonna be setting the target you're using for your EDM, you have to be sure you're using the correct target. So let's go and let's take our EDM out of the box now. So always when you open the box, when you open in the box, you just need to make sure this is actually the right way, it's not upside down. So TS15, now you know it's open like this, just click it, pops up, and then just open it up, and there your EDM. So in the box you really got the EDM itself, you got the place for the batteries like here. There should be cover for the EDM, it's like a yellow cover, rain cover, which you can use obviously when it's raining. And then let's take the EDM out of the box. I just have to do it single-handedly, so it's not that. You should usually use two hands, really. So that's our EDM out of the box here. I'm just gonna move it a little bit closer, and I'm gonna tell you a few things about it. So as you can see, in the face of the EDM, we got the keyboard here. Just the buttons, you got turn on button, we're gonna turn it on in a minute, a few buttons here, and the screen. On the right hand side you can open this here, this is Bluetooth, and you got access there also to the USB and SD card if you want to use one. You see there is a USB, SD and PC, so you can plug it into the computer as well. So you just close it, turn it right. And on the other side, on the left hand side, you're going to find the same turn on, turn off. To open it, and where you're going to find the battery. So you're just taking battery out of it. That's it really, it shows you here, plus, minus. So when you change the battery next time, you just make sure it's this way. Press it in, turn, and the battery is changed. What you need to really know about the EDM as well when you're gonna start using it, you got your zoom obviously here, so when you're gonna be aiming at the targets or when you're gonna be looking at the target, you just move in this one to zoom in and out. And this closer one here, you just adjusting your crosshair to make a clear view of the target. And if you have a look here on top, I don't know if you're gonna see this. Oh, maybe you're gonna see normally a two white lines at the cross, which you're gonna use like from further distance. You just to firstly aim at the target you can use this one, and then obviously you're gonna jump into the zoom in out, and you're gonna find your target. Same with the at the bottom here, you got the same cross here, so it's really useful. You just look for it from the further distance. You look through this, and then you're gonna jump in and look for the target closely. So in this EDM, you're gonna have an antenna here as well, which you can turn up. But to be honest with you, on sites, I never use this, as we work within a couple of hundred meters maximum. So I just normally keep it down. And then in the instrument, you of course gonna find the bubble, which you're gonna be using to level your instrument when we're gonna be doing resection and setting out. So guys, I think that's all really about the EDM from the outside. I'm gonna show you the controller. So the controller here we're using for TS15 is the CS15 controller. And I'm gonna show you how to change the battery in this. So just push it up, take it. You just take the battery out, put back in, you're gonna change. We're gonna start charging this one. We're gonna put the fully charged one. Press down and then push this one down. And that's your battery change. You're gonna find here in your controller, you're gonna find a stylus, and then it's not only a stylus really, because at the end of it, it's like a small Allen key, let's say, and you're gonna use this key to open your the head of the controller, and then you're gonna find your SD card. I'll just show you quickly. Yeah, I just put it here between my legs. Yes. So here on top now, when we took the, let's call it head of the controller, you got an SD card which you're gonna press and you're gonna pop out. So there you're gonna be probably keeping all of your job and data. So I'm gonna press it back and we're gonna put the head back and screw it again. So that's back. Let's use our stylus. On the bottom of the controller, you're gonna find as well the access for your USB stick and connection to your computer as well. There is antenna also here, which you opening up this way. But it's very gentle equipment, and then, as I said, with the EDM, I never open antenna, so I never use it on the controller as well. Unless you're gonna be working on the very far distances, maybe you're gonna use it. So I forgot to tell you about the stylus here. You got one with the EDM as well. It's hiding here. You just slide it out. This one is just a stylo without a small key. So you just slide it back in. So let's turn on EDM now, and I'm gonna show you the screen. So the turn on button is, as you can see here, so we just press and hold, and then you're gonna see the screen. It usually takes a while till it's gonna turn on completely. And as you can see here on the screen, this is Viva. So the software used in the TS15, it's called Viva, and the same is in the controller. So in the TS15, you're gonna have this software on the EDM itself and in the controller. So unlike TS12, for instance, where you can use only the software on the controller, here you can actually operate EDM without the controller, and you can use all the options from the EDM. You can save some jobs there as well. And yeah, SmartWorks Viva here. So you're gonna see that's usually the first. This obviously depends on settings, but I really like to start from this screen when you're gonna see if your instrument is level or not. You can press next and we're gonna see the settings on the next screen. So we're gonna talk about the settings in the next video. I think we're gonna go through the settings, we're gonna set a new job, we're gonna type in some new coordinates, points, which we're gonna use later for resection and setting out the lines and the levels as well. So we're gonna turn on the controller now and you're gonna see that it will automatically connect with the total station. So see the Leica Viva, it starts, it's gonna take a while as well. So you probably could see on the EDM, and now you're gonna see the flashing lights which is connected, and it shows it will be connected from now on. You're gonna see the same screen which shows you the level of the instrument, so you're just gonna tap next. And on the instrument you're gonna see that this total station is currently being remotely controlled. So that's actually on your settings. Your EDM gonna be automatically connected with the controller, and now it's fully remotely controlled, and that's how I'm gonna be using it in the later videos. What I'm gonna show you in this video is the prism, but it's nothing really interesting about it. It just, as I said before, you just need to know what prism you are using, and we got the holder here, which will be a bit difficult to show you right now, but then you just put your prism in here, and then on the prism itself there is a small button here which you press. So you press down and go down with the prism, and now it's locked. On the handle you got a bubble as well, so when you set it out you need to make sure you keep it straight in level. And then there is a holder for the controller, which actually I need to show you how to use it. I'll just maybe take it out for a while. To put your controller here correctly, you just need to go down a bit this thing, and then you just press it, so you see it clicks in like this. And then to make it secure you just press this red thingy in, and now it's secured. So we can come back really to our pole and we can secure it using this bolt. Now obviously you don't need to take it out to install the controller, as you're going to be doing it just on this handle, it will be fixed all the time. And this bolt here, really, if you get it loose a little bit, just don't crazy with it, you can turn your controller wherever is useful for you. Which way? This way. So I think that will be all for this video, and in next video I'm gonna show you guys the settings in the instrument. We're gonna go through the jobs, we're gonna open the job, we're gonna put new points, I'm gonna show you how to set your EDM, and then we're gonna jump another videos. So we're gonna be doing resection and setting out in field. Guys, that's it in today's video. I really hope you enjoyed it, and I believe you just make another step forward in your setting out site engineering knowledge. If you have any questions, if something was unclear, please let me know, leave in the comment below. And please guys, subscribe to my channel and turn the notifications on so you're gonna know when my next video gonna be released. So thank you again for watching and see you next time back on my channel.